in the description, you'll find a more in-depth guide and some general information about the people who found the secret. Of course, it wasn't me. No, I just found this on WoW Secret Finding Discord, which is a great Discord to just great people that look around in WoW and find secrets, try and crack codes. And whenever something is found in the data files that just looks a little off, that it like is in the game, they always try and crack it. This one was solved in about 16 hours, which is just insane to think about. They were at this like day and night, so just a quick shout out to them for finding this. In update 7.2.5, a new update was added to World of Warcraft Legion that added a new companion upon completion. This puzzle requires players to do rather awkward and unusual things with items that they wouldn't usually try to go out of their way to obtain or even have in their inventory, really. Before beginning the puzzle, it's recommended that the players have the following items in their inventory. One of each of the major protection potions, including Fire, Arcane, Frost, Holy, Nature, and Shadow. Then players must also have 10 Noggenfogger elixirs, even though you don't necessarily need 10, it's just chance proc. Scotty's Lucky Coin, which is dropped by an elite enemy in Pandaria. They must have a Dire Brew, which will be found in Blackrock Depths. They need an Ethereal Oil, one Gordok Ogre Suit, and note, this suit, you can only get one per character unless you have a recipe that was removed from the game or know a leather worker that's able to craft them. You need a Winterfall Fire Water. You need 10 Pygmy Oil, or just enough to get the proc. You don't exactly need 10. You need a Perky Pug, which is a battle pet. And for the Perky Pug, you need a Little Princess costume, which can be purchased by most pet vendors for some pet charms. And you need a Scroll of Intellect. All of the items will be selling for outrageous prices because people are trying to scalp market, and I don't necessarily blame them, but I was able to pick up each of the protection potions for about 2,000 gold. It's really not that bad. So to begin, you're going to want to find the Cavern of Consumption, which is found on the coast of Winterspring. It's kind of like in between Moonglade and Winterspring to the northern point of the map. Once you're inside the Cavern of Consumption, you're going to want to consume all of your major potions. This is going to take about 6 minutes. I definitely recommend consuming the fire one first, so you can get past the first barrier while you're killing time anyways. As soon as you pass the fail barrier, you're going to want to consume your Noggenfogger elixir until you turn into a skeleton. If you don't, the Digilent Watcher is going to catch you, and you're going to teleport all the way back to the beginning. This just wastes time, and you don't want to be wasting time when you're on a time limit. Once past the Digilent Watcher, you're going to want to hug the right side of the wall until you make it to the vines. Once at the vines, you won't be able to pass until you flip Scotty's Lucky Coin. This will transform you into Scotty, which will be able to pass through the vines. Once you're in the room, you're going to want to grab the Water Stone from the ground. These are unique. The Water Stone will allow you to pass through the Blue Barrier. As soon as you make it to the Blue Barrier, you're going to want to use your Dire Brew. The Dire Brew prevents you being caught by the Stone Watcher. If you're caught by the Stone Watcher, just as the Digilent Watcher, you're going to be brought back to the beginning of the little puzzle. Once you run past the Stone Watcher, there's going to be two different paths you can take. One leads down into the egg room, which you can't access at the moment. One leads up to where two puzzles are. You're going to want to take the upward path. Once you take the upward path, you're going to want to look right, and you're going to see a translucent purple wall. To pass through the barrier, you're going to take the Ethereal Oil. This will make you translucent, being able to pass through. Once you're inside, you're going to want to use the Gordok Ogre Suit, and you're going to want to drink the Winterfall Water. Then you're going to want to interact, and you'll be able to stick your arm in to get a buff. After this buff's obtained, you're going to want to make it to the other side, to the other puzzle. This puzzle is blocked by a gate, and to access it, you're going to have to drink your pygmy oil until you transform into a pygmy. The pygmy is short enough to pass through the bars. Once inside of the room with the wisdom cube, you're going to want to summon your perky pug, and once your perky pug is summoned, you're going to want to give it the princess costume. This will allow the next buff to be obtained, which will then allow you to access the egg. Once the buff's obtained, you're going to want to leave the room, and you're going to want to take the downward path. I kind of lied. The only thing that's going to be preventing you now from obtaining your new companion is going to be a huge puddle of water. You're going to be wanting to remove your fire water buff and using your scroll of intellect. This will allow you to cross over the water and get your new companion.